We want to find the area of the shaded region using a definite integral, where if the function is continuous and non-negative on the closed interval from a to b, then the area under the function and above the x-axis is equal to the integral of f of x from a to b. So looking at the shaded region, notice how the interval for x is the closed interval from 2 to 6, which means for our definite integral, a is equal to positive 2, and b is equal to positive 6. Next, f of x is the linear function graphed here in blue, and we should be able to find the equation of our linear function by using slope-intercept form, or the form y equals mx plus b. Looking at the graph of the line, notice how the y-intercept is positive 7, which means b equals positive 7. And now if we select two points on the line, we should be able to find the slope of the line. So if we use the y-intercept and this point here, notice how we'd have to go down 1 unit. So the change in y is negative 1, and then right 2 units. So the change in x is positive 2, and therefore the slope of the line is equal to negative 1/2. So our function f of x is equal to negative 1/2 x plus 7. Now to find the area of the function, notice how the shaded region is a trapezoid. So we can use this area formula here to find the area of the shaded region or evaluate the definite integral. For a trapezoid, base 1 and base 2 are the two parallel sides. So let's call this base 1 or b sub 1. And we'll call this base 2 or b sub 2, which means this length here would be the height. So b sub 1 would be 6 units, b sub 2 would be 4 units, and the height would also be 4 units. So the area of the shaded region would be equal to 1/2 times the sum of the two bases, which would be 6 plus 4, times the height, which is also 4. So we have 1/2 times 10, that's 5. 5 times 4 is 20. So the area of the shaded region, or the value of the definite integral, would be 20. So to put all these pieces together and summarize, we can say the area is equal to the definite integral of f of x, which is negative 1/2 x plus 7, from 2 to 6 is equal to 20. I hope you found this explanation helpful.